Good morning to all. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Okay, so last week we are discussing about the demonstration. Demonstration for connecting the sensors to the Arduino board, of course, to the Raspberry Pi, and how do we collect the data and how do we process the data. We planned for the today. So before we move on to those demonstrations, any queries from your side? Yes, please. Any doubts? Are you able to see the kits?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I think Deepika, she was mentioning she has the kit, Arduino kit.
Yes, sir.
Is it possible from your side to connect, or shall I connect from my side?
Sir, the thing is, I don't really have any sensors.
Last week, you were mentioning about the servo motor and other some DHT sensors are there?
I don't have a DHT sensor. I have a servo motor.
Okay. 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 So, are they available with you now? Servo motor and Arduino board?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. Today in today's session we will have your demo also. Is it okay?
Yes, sir. Sure.
Yeah, fine. So I'm just waiting for someone to join the our session. So if you have any queries before we move on to the demonstration, please let me know. So class is very silent. So it looks like you're not, maybe you are busy with other things. So anyway, I hope you can see this Arduino board.
Sir, one doubt regarding the assignment submission.
Yeah, yeah.
Sir, do we need to build a fridging schema for each and every question or problem?
No, not for all the questions, only for that one which I asked it.
Only the pump problem or something?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, sir.
Not for all the questions. You cannot put a schema for your mobile app.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me move on. So if at all you have any queries, please let me know. So I hope you can see this is basically your the real Arduino board. Of course, last week's we are discussing about the simulators, but let us do some practicals on this particular the real Arduino board, so to make you to have some confidence that it is not as different as with that simulator which we have practiced in the last week's class. So this Arduino board is basically Uno version. So Arduino boards will have different variants. Variants in the sense some boards will have Wi-Fi capabilities, some boards will have only a minimal GPIO pins, some boards will have different microcontroller. Atmega microcontroller is with a different board, but a microcontroller in generic. So we have different versions of Arduino boards. So the one I am showing you is basically an Arduino Uno board. So it has got the capability to read analog as well as digital data. So this has got some pins which can help you to read digital sensors data as well as with the analog outputs which you get it from your sensors. So here I brought three different types of sensors. So let me show you. So the one which you are going to see it here is basically, this is one particular sensor, is a DHT sensor, a digital humidity and temperature. And digital humidity and temperature, of course, this is basically a three pin. You can see there are three pins are there here, which are output. So you have a different variants again in this DHT. One is with the four pin and another will be with the three pin. So the three pin has got a resistor. You can see there is a resistor at the side of this. So that's why that pull up resistor which is there, which will help you to convert your voltage values properly to read the ambient temperature and the humidity values. So here these three pins, this is one DHT, this is one type of sensor, basically a digital. So internally you have the conversion from analog to digital. So he can directly get the digital values from this output of this particular sensor. This is one particular sensor. So now let me show you another one. Nivas Mandal, you cannot.
Actually, this is too close, so it is out of focus.
What about now? Is it clear now?
Yes.
Nibas, can't you see the video? Oh, what is that you are not able to see? Are you not able to see the sensor or the video? Can you speak out, Nibas? Yeah. What about now? Can you see the sensor, Nivas?
No, sir. Actually, only the video visible, you and the mobile.
You are not looking to see. I am showing a video. Please look into in your gallery. There will be another video with the sensors, not with me. You look into your gallery. See, how many participants are there in this session now?
Including me, 13 others.
No, it will be 17 are there at present. Now 18. Now see, what I suggest to you is, there is a video which is being presented. So you need to pin to that particular video. With my name only. Still you are unable to get it, Nivas.
Yes, I'm getting it right now.
Can you see the video now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here, what I am showing is one particular sensor. This sensor is basically called as the DHT, digital humidity and temperature 11, the number of that particular sensor. So this is one particular DHT sensor, which has got three pins. Can you see the three pins here? I'm just putting it a little bit close.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So these three pins, I'll talk about these pins in a short while. Just hold on. So this DHT sensor has got another version also with four pins. So what is the difference between the three pin and the four pin? I will get back to you. Just hold on. First, let you first you see this particular sensor. Okay. So now once you this is one particular sensor, this DHT sensor. Okay. Now I'm showing you another sensor here. Can you see a PCB board, printed circuit board here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you, I hope everybody is able to see this printed circuit board here. Now, the one which I am pointing it with my finger, can you see this is one another sensor here? I'm just bringing it very near. Okay. The one here, which is in the black color one. This black color one also has got a three pins. So this black color one, of course, in this PCB, you have three LEDs. One is orange, red, green, and another is this black color one. There's another sensor here, and there is another potentiometer. This is a potentiometer. So this particular thing, what you are seeing is basically is another sensor. This is basically a temperature sensor. Only temperature, ambient temperature, the environmental temperature is going to be taken, and it is going to give the output for you. So here, this ambient temperature, the number of the sensor is TMP35. So last week we are discussing about this TMP35 and DHT sensor. So what is TMP35 is basically for? Anyone please?
Analog sensor to measure temperature.
Yes, it is an analog sensor to measure the temperature. You will get the analog value from this temperature sensor. The output of this is basically a analog value. Please remember it. So this is a TMP35. The number, of course, no need to memorize all these numbers, but at least you try to understand there is a difference between analog and a digital sensors. That's what the point of discussion here. So this is an analog sensor, and analog value is going to come out from this particular transducer. That is a sensor. Whereas this is a digital DHT. So this DHT is basically a temperature and humidity. Of course, there is one more here, humidity value also you are going to get it. But in this one, you are going to get only a temperature, but it is basically an analog value. Now, one more thing I am going to show you here. This let me show you. I'll just take out from the breadboard. Can you see now one more sensor I'm showing you here? Can anybody, yes, yeah, can yes, anybody, can anybody tell what is this particular sensor is? Yes, please. Are you able to see the sensor now? How many pins are there on the, for this sensor?
Four.
Yes, just four pins are there here. To be very, let me just put very near to you. So there are four sensors. Four pins are there. Now this particular is also a temperature sensor. On the top, you can see this is what actually a black color one. So this is a small sensor, black color. It is also a digital temperature, but this particular this particular sensor, basically this PCB, printed circuit board, as what it has got is, it has, you can also have the analog value. So it, this one has got analog as well as digital. So this is one sensor, whereas this is basically you are going to have only analog value. This is analog temperature, analog temperature value you are going to get it. And whereas this is completely a digital temperature and humidity. So three types of sensors you can see it here now. So one is the digital DHT, another is your analog one, and another one is a digital and analog, both the digital and analog you are going to have. So let us have these three practice for today's session, and I'll give some demonstration and we'll try to go it on to the next one. So before we connect it, so let me just show you. I have an Arduino board, so I'm going to take out the existing connections and connect it back for you. So on the Arduino board, so this is what your Arduino board. And of course, now can you see what is this cable is? This cable, what is the use of this cable? Can you see it on my?
Yes, sir, it powers on the board.
Which board?
The Arduino board.
Okay, right. So that's the Arduino board. So I'm just connecting to the Arduino board. So at one end you have connected your Arduino board, the USB end, that's what your USB end. This USB end I'm going to connect to my laptop. The laptop, but before I make the power on, so I will connect the pins for the I'll connect the pins for the sensor and as well as Arduino board. So I'm using a breadboard. You can see what type of breadboard is this? In your fridging circuit, you might have different breadboards.
Half boards.
Yeah, half board is in a half breadboard. So on the breadboard, I am just connecting the digital sensor. So I just pushed in my digital sensor onto my breadboard. Can you see that one?
Yes, sir.
Right. So basically this, one second I'm plugging out so that I'll just give you some information for this. So how many pins are there here? It's basically four pins. You can see it on the net also. If you want to be clear, so let me just present here and show you this particular pin onto my laptop itself for you to have the specifications for that. You can see here on my screen. Can you able to see on my screen now? There are different types of digital sensors. The one which I'm referring is one, this particular sensor. Can you see that now?
Yes, sir.
So this is the one which I'm referring here. This is a digital temperature sensor module. You can see the diagrams on your laptops also. The pin diagrams, and see there is the four pins are there. So these four pins are basically, you are connecting it to your Arduino board using, you can fridging circuit connect, but I am now really connecting onto this. So what are those four output pins? So this particular sensor, what I told you is you can get it your analog value as well as your digital value. So you can measure your analog value as well as your digital value. So what you have, this four pins. So one of the pin is getting the analog output, and another pin is coming, you are getting your digital output. And for any sensor, please remember, there will be a minimum of two pins. One will be your VCC or your positive, and the other one will be your ground. So every sensor, please remember, minimum two pins, that is one your To have the power on to your sensor, you require your positive and negative, your anode and a cathode. So those two, you're definitely will be there, those two, plus and minus. So the plus indicates you the your plus and minus both indicates to have a power on to be supplied to that particular sensor. Power on supplying means you need to provide energy to that particular sensor. So in addition to this plus and minus, or in addition to this plus and ground, you will have another two pins which are coming out from the sensor. Is basically your one is your analog, and another is one is your analog, and another is your digital. So you can see here carefully in this diagram. Let me just enlarge this diagram so that you can see it. Yeah, you can see it here. This is a, you can see the four pins. So on one pin it is written A0, on another pin it is written G, another pin it is written plus, and another pin it is written D0. So D0 is basically your digital. Zero you can call it as, or you can call it as O also, digital output. Your another is A0, or you can have an analog output. Another one is your ground, that is your minus. The other pin is your plus, that is for your positive. So these are the four pins. So that four pins, now I am trying to connect those four pins to my Arduino board. So the Arduino board connections, so something like this, very similar to this. You can see again, let us go with this diagram now. So here in this diagram, what I am doing is the digital output is connected to which particular pin of the Arduino board, please, on this diagram? Hello? Yeah, pin number two, the digital pin number two of the Arduino board. You can see here the green color line. So that is connected to D0. D0 or digital output of this temperature sensor. Now, of course, A0 is connected to A0 analog output of this sensor is connected by a blue the blue color line to which particular pin of the Arduino board?
A0.
A0 only, same thing. That analog output of sensor is again connected to the analog A0 of your analog pin of your Arduino board. So the remaining two pins are, what are the remaining two pins, please? One is your positive, another is your negative. So the positive is connected to how much power supply? How much power is needed for this sensor to active or to be switched on?
5 volts.
That's what you can see, that red color line. The red color line is what your power supply, which is connected to the Arduino board, 5 volts. And of course, the ground G of the sensor is again connected to the ground of this. So that completes your entire circuit. You know how to do this fridging. That's what I told you. You can go through that fridging process and you can understand this particular diagram. Just nothing. It is not very difficult task at all. You just to connect the respective pins. The pins of this temperature sensor, digital temperature sensors, are connected to the Arduino. The same thing I'm now using the jumper wires. So let me just stop presenting from this laptop, and I'll just present it from my. Okay, now can you see this particular mobile phone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So I'm just connecting this digital sensor onto this breadboard. Right. So what are the pins to be connected? So here, this is the Arduino board which I am using here. Now the power supply, the ground is getting the ground of this Arduino board is ground of this sensor. Then the analog output 2 0 wire is connected to analog and the 5 volts is connected to the BSD. Yes. So here, so we have just connected this temperature sensor to the Arduino board. It's very simple once you connect them. All right. So before we power on, are you able to see my laptop screen, please? Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So now let us. Go to the Arduino IDE. Right. So I am just taking the same program, a sample program which this guy has given to us. So the same program, I am just copying it. So how to write this Arduino program is one which we have already practiced on the simulator. The same process, there is no difference here at all. Right. So here, I just copied the same program from the sample. So now what can you, let me explain to you, or you will be able to explain to me. Yeah, can you please tell me what has been shown here? Yes, please. Same simulator program only, simulator setups. Yep. Yeah, Deepika, can you please start? What do you see it on the Arduino IDE now?
Sir, first we are just setting the like first we're just declaring a few variables like indicating the LED and the digital pin and all of those. We are initializing them.
Yes. Sir.
And in setup,
yeah,
we...
it's okay. Now I'll just move to the next person. Nibas, can you please tell me what is the use of setup function and loop function of the Arduino? Just to have an interaction with you, please.
For the setup functions, we need to set the pin mode.
Yes,
for that
the pin as... mode means the your GPIO pins. What is that those pins are used for? The GPIO pins which are used on your Arduino board, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is the first statement? Pin mode. The pin mode is
yeah. LED and as output.
Yeah, which particular LED? LED is been given with the pin number. Which pin number of your Arduino board?
So it's given on the pin number 13.
13, yes. So on your Arduino board, at pin number 13, there is a small LED. Okay, that has been made as that particular pin. The pin number 13 is made as what mode it is?
It is output mode, sir.
Output mode, perfectly. Then the next instruction. What is the next instruction, please?
It's for the digital pin as
yes.
Input.
Yes, the digital pin. Digital pin is which particular pin?
It's a pin number 2.
Pin number 2. That's what you can see it on the Arduino board. On the digital side, we are connected one wire, that is your jumper wire, is connected to the pin number 2. Right.
Yes.
So now, yeah. So now, what is the serial dot begin 9600?
So it will begin start.
Yeah, your serial. Your serial means. What is the meaning of serial here?
Serial port.
Serial so number port. Of it should transfer to the serial monitor.
Yeah.
Baud rate is 9600.
Yeah, the baud rate. Baud rate means the data rate. Data rate is basically the number of bits sent per second. So you are connecting that Arduino board. Basically, I'm going to connect that Arduino board to my laptop using the USB serial. That's what this is your USB connection. This USB connection is connected to your COM port or to your USB port. Usually in the olden days, COM ports. Now nowadays, because your COM ports are replaced mostly by your USB ports, you are connecting it to your USB. So you are going to the data that is coming from your Arduino board. Please remember that. So data coming from temperature sensor is taken by your Arduino board. Your Arduino board is giving the data to my laptop, and you can see it on your serial monitor. That's what the so the data rate, the bits that you are going to receive it will be in terms of 9600 bits per second. That is the baud rate. That is a standard baud rate for any data communication to take place from one device to another device. Okay. Who can take? Who can say the next? What is the use of loop function?
So actually, in Arduino, it starts looping like that. One program is executed again and again, so we put everything under the loop.
Not one program is again and again. A particular program continuously is in the execution state only until unless some interrupt comes, until unless somebody stops that, until unless somebody some program execution is going to be interrupted here. It is in a continuous loop. Okay, so yeah, Nibas, then who else is there on today's session? Sonali, can you please tell me what does this loop function is going to do?
Yes, sir. It will start reading from digital pin.
Yes, so the first instruction, please look to the first instruction. Digital read is a function. That digital read is function is taking the parameter as an argument from the digital pin. Pin number, which one is that pin number?
Pin number 2.
So that is the pin number 2. That is basically you are getting some data here. That is what is in input mode. That GPIO pin of Arduino is made as an input mode. So you are reading it and storing it. Where are you storing those values?
In variable name digital val.
Digital val. Just only a digital read. This is just a digital value. So the digital values. So how the values will be looking like digital values?
0 or 1.
0 or 1, very good, perfect. So that particular value, you're again, what is the next line, please? The next line is the next instruction.
It's printing that digital yes. value.
Yes, you are just printing it the digital value onto your console screen. So again, you have written a conditional statement here. If digital value is equal to high means?
High means 1.
1. Then you digital write, the LED should be?
Glow.
So which LED should be high? Which LED should be glowing?
Which will be having on 13.
Yes, on 13 pin. Yes, very good. So else digital right LED should be low. So this is one just making the digital value you are reading it. And the another value which you are going to read is here is?
Analog value.
Analog value. So you are using analog read function. Analog read function. From which particular pin are we reading this analog value?
Pin number A0, sir.
Print number A0, very good, perfect. That value you are going to print it on your
console.
Yes. So again, delay 100. What is the meaning of 100 here?
0.1 seconds.
100 milliseconds.
How much? 0.1?
100 milliseconds.
Yeah. What is this delay? Why we require a delay here, please?
Properly see the means output, whether it means.
So for every iteration, for every continuous value, so you want to see one by one. So you need to little bit pause between the subsequent values. That is what for that purpose only. Just other than that, nothing. There need not be any delays also here. Okay, right. So that's fine. Shankanil, can you please tell me how do you? Okay, once you have written your program. What is that we need to do it on the Arduino board? Arduino IDE?
So we need to burn the program into the Arduino IDE and we have to run it.
Yes. So see, please look onto my screen. I hope you are able to see my screen now. So here, let me just maximize it once again. My cursor pointer is pointing to which particular?
So verify.
Verify, yes. So I'm just, once I write the code here, I'm going to click the verify. So once verify, what is happening here, please see at the bottom of my screen, compiling the sketch. So once it has been compiled, once there are no errors, this is basically your C and C++ program. Please remember, in the beginning session only, I told your Arduino programs are basically written in the C and C++ programming concepts only. Using C and C++ programming concepts, we are writing this particular sketch. We call it as a sketch. We can call it as your programming code. that needs to be burned onto your hardware. That is basically what you are writing is a firmware software. It is a firmware. It's not exactly a software. It is basically a firmware. So once your compilation is done, that's what you get an output, done compiling. So then what is the next step I'm going to do?
So to click on the upload button and it will burn.
So you can see it on now. Now I'm just powering on. Once it is compiled and you locally check the annoyance, now I'm going to power on. You can see power on means I'm just connecting the audio board to my laptop. Yes. Once it is connected, you see now there's a, can you see this temperature sensor? It is also been powered on and Arduino board is also powered on. Can you see the lights, please? LED lights of Arduino board and the temperature sensor?
Yes, sir.
Right. So once you have done the compiling, what you need to do is you need to upload it. Before uploading, please remember, you go to the tools and make sure your port. This is your serial port. That is your serial port which I connected. That is your COM8, which has been highlighted. And another important step is you need to make sure which particular Arduino board, because Arduino boards are various Arduino variants are there. You can see Arduino Yun, Arduino Uno, Arduino Nano, Arduino Omega, Arduino Leonardo, Arduino Micro, Arduino Esclero, Arduino Mini, Arduino Ethernet, Arduino Lilypads. The different companies' Arduino boards are also there here. So I am just selected the Arduino Uno. That is a genuine Arduino board. So this is what has been selected. And you need to also check for your COM ports, which is serially connected to this your laptop. So once it has been connected, you just please upload. So you can see it on my screen. Now I'm just clicking upload. You can see uploading process is happening on the bottom of my screen. So it says done uploading. So once it is done uploading, now you can go to your serial monitor right side of your screen, right side of my screen, you can see the serial monitor. So now you can see there are some values are coming. Yeah, can anybody say what are these values are basically? Hello?
So that 10 is digital value and 0 to 215 is analog.
There is no zero values you are getting here, only one followed by. One second, I'm clearing the output. You can see here 1 1 1 followed by 213 212. So you can see the now. Tell me the logic. What you are seeing on the logic is there on the left side of the program. The digital high value, that is one, indicates the digital high value. And if you see on the Arduino board, on the pin number 13, there is an LED glowing here. Can you see that one? Hello, color. The pin number 13 LED glowing. And you are getting the analog values, that is the analog value, that is analog values which are been converted. Those analog values are nothing but your 210, 212, 213, something like that, 211. So just a constant value will not be there. So it is, but it will be in the range between 210 to 213 only. So that's what you are just, that's what serial.print line. So you are getting the temperatures analog to digitally converted value. You are not getting the exact temperature value. You got the ADC value here. ADC means analog to digital converted value. And this value is, if you want to exact temperature value, then what we need to do here? Hello? Am I audible to you, please?
Sir, we can map analog values to centigrade or something.
Yeah, there will be a formula for converting your ADC values to corresponding temperature values in centigrade or in Fahrenheit. So there will be a formula for that one. it depends on the type of temperature sensors which you use. So the temperature sensor, the one which you are using, is only to display your analog to digital converted value. So there is no conversion here. So if you want to have a converted value, then what needs to be done here? Can anybody tell me what needs to be done in the program? Yes, please. You need to write the
formula. You have to write the formula for the converter, I mean, analog value to converter, using the analog val variable, and then you have to like print it in the serial.
Very simple. That's all. That's all. You already have that value in the variable, and you take that variable and put it in the formula and display it. That is one particular demo that we are now seeing today for today. Okay, now let me just show you the next demo. Any queries here, please? The same, it is actually, this is the same example that almost the similar to which we have seen in the simulator. So there is no much difference between the simulator program and this. So people who do not have these Arduino boards, do not worry about this. You can directly use your simulators and start practicing these things. That's what I was trying to tell you from the beginning. Okay, now let us move on to the next demo. Again, we'll come back to this. Again, Arduino programs is not yet over. We'll come back to that. Let me just show you different variations of these setups and how to collect the programs and how to read it. So here, what you have seen here is basically you are able to see the values here on the serial monitor, but you are unable to store these values. Please remember, we have not written any program to store these values or to process this collected value. You are just seeing it. You are not even storing it. You are not collecting it. Please remember, it is just only viewing on your serial monitor. You are not storing nor doing any processing of that data that is being stored, or you are not doing any analysis. Please remember, just this is only viewing that you are seeing that the data is being seen on your serial monitor through your serial COM port. That is the only thing that we have done so far here. You just keep remembering, we'll move on to the next one. So now let me show you, there's another one. So can you see this one now? Can you see a printed circuit board which I'm showing to you now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. So this is the printed circuit board which I have used while I was started my learning for this wireless sensor networks and Internet of Things almost in the year 2010. So this is the board which I have developed it, and this is the basic principle for my designing and developing various other electronic sensors and all. So if you are very much thorough in this one, definitely you can understand the fundamentals behind, and most likely all the practical ingredients you will get it for you to develop your IoT things, that's what you call it, as sensor things and all. So of course, I will not make you to do these PCBs at this moment, but try to understand. So very simple sensor is there here. So what you see here is basically this is what a temperature sensor. A TMP. TMP, what is this called as? TMP 35. Temperature, only temperature. And the output of this one is basically you get it analog. It is not a digital values one. But this is going to be more accurate than the digital sensors, please remember. And this is going to collect the ambient temperature. So this is one temperature sensor is put. Along with this one, you have three LEDs on this board. So one is orange color, another is red color, another is a green color. And there is a potentiometer, and of course there are two wires are there. You might understand what is this, what are this, the purpose of these two wires. One is your for connecting it to the positive power supply. The another is for your negative power supply. That is your to your battery. So now there is another provision is there in this PCB. A provision means to hold another electronic gadget or another electronic device. So this another electronic device is nothing but it is this one place. Basically, what you call it as ZigBee, or we call it as XBee. So this particular, you can see it on my screen. So this is an XBee. You can see, you can, this kind of things you can find it on the net also. So this is, we call it as an XBee. Basically, this XBee is a radio communication module, or you can call it as an RF module. RF module. So this is XBee. It has got certain pins. You can see the pins here. So here you have 10 pins on one side and the 10 pins on the other side. And please remember, this has got an inbuilt microcontroller. Already a microcontroller is present inside this particular chip, and we buy it from the market. This has been produced by Digi company, DIGI, Digi company. So we can directly just buy this one, these kinds of stuffs from the Amazon also. Let me just show you this particular XBee. What is this? You can see it on the screen. You can just Google it, you will get that complete information. So you can see these are called XBees. That's what I was, I'm just trying to show you. This particular XBee is basically one particular, yeah. So you can see this is XBee. You can get more information on this later. We'll go for the next week also. So just have an idea about at this moment. So this is basically a ZigBee mesh kind of electronic gadget, which we use it for our Internet of Things, for most of your applications. This can be very much handy for us. So this has got an inbuilt microcontroller. So what we do here is, okay, now see here carefully, what I do is, can you see it on my screen now? This ZigBee, XBee, what I'm doing is, I'm just pushing it onto this particular board. That's what the provision is here. So the provision is to just to place this XBee. Just hold on. The pins are very sensitive here. You can just push it onto this. So once you can put it, your device is going to look like this, please. So what we have done is, this temperature sensor, TMP35, is connected to this XBee, to one of the pin. So once the analog value is read by this particular gadget, internally the microcontroller will be there that will convert that analog value to digital value. And that value, you can send it through wireless. So you can, through wireless communication, you can receive this temperature value. If you put this particular device at a particular location, you can receive it from that particular through wireless to your computer, that is to your coordinator. So to receive this one, on the other side, we will have another device, which we call it as a coordinator. So this is what a coordinator. So the same thing. On one side, you will have a coordinator. You can see here, this is your coordinator. On the other side, you'll have your actual device. So both the coordinator, the coordinator is going to be connected to your laptop like this. Just I'm connecting at one end of my coordinator. We have the USB connector. You connect this particular USB connector to this laptop. The laptop is connected. So now your coordinator is powered on. So you can see the coordinator, a ZigBee, which is meant for to collect the data wirelessly from another ZigBee. From another ZigBee is, this is your another ZigBee, which has got a temperature sensor. So now only thing is, this has to be powered on. Now, usually I use battery to power on this. So can anybody tell me how much energy is required for this particular sensing system to be powered on? Hello, am I audible to you, please?
So 9 volts.
9 volts. Who has given this answer? Anurag. Okay. Any other views, please? Please come forward. Just I would like to hear from you. What is your understanding?
3.3 or 5 volts.
3.3 or 5 volts.
Like because I heard Zigbee is a very light protocol. So.
Lightweight protocol
and Bluetooth and all. So.
Okay. Any other answers, please? Any other views? Jagadish. Jagadish, are you online? Yes, sir. So please tell me, I am just connected. I mean, so one device is ready for me to power on. This device has got a temperature sensor and an XB. XB is basically a Zigbee device. How much power is required for this?
Sir, I think 5 volt.
I think 5 volt. Okay. I'm not expecting the correct answer, but I'm expecting how do you determine it? In other terms, how do you judge or how do you say or how do you come to a conclusion how much power supply is required? Or in what way you have to think how much power supply is to be given to this? So in order to miss what should be, sir, your thought process, that's what I'm expecting the answer, please.
Between,
sorry,
distance between the sending device and receiving device also matters.
No, that is the communication capabilities. I'm not asking about the communication QoS parameters, the distance and the delays and all these things. I'm just asking, see, this needs some power, this needs some energy, so that this will be active, this will be working. If you want to provide this some power, how much will you be able to provide, or how much to judge, or how much to think? I'm just expecting your thought process. What is that you are thinking? How much can be energy can be supplied to this?
Sir, yes. Generally it will be provided in the data sheet of the sensor.
Very good. At least one you are on the right track now. Syed Imtiaz, can you please tell me how much power supply can be given to this one?
I don't have an idea, sir.
Don't have an idea? Okay. So can it? I will make you to give the answer. Just hold on. See, please try to respond to me. Okay.
Sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, can we guess based on the number of inputs we are taking, like number of pins which we use for taking input or sending output?
No, it is not the number of pins.
Okay.
I'll tell you, Syed. Yes, Deepika, please tell me what is your answer. You're trying to.
Sir, would it depend on the resistors?
Will it depend on the resistors? No. Any other answers, please? Vishal. Vishal, can you please tell me what can be this? How much power supply is required for this? What is your idea? What is your thought process? Hello? We are unable to hear you, Vishal. Can you please speak loudly? Okay. Syed Imtiaz?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please tell me what are all the things that are there on this board I told you.
Hello, sir.
I was mentioning if you are online, can you please tell me what are all the things are there on this board? Can you see the board? First of all, can you see the board here? Aryan, are you online?
Yes, sir.
So can you tell me what are all the things which are there on this board?
LED, register.
Yes, LEDs, resistors.
Sensor, temperature sensor.
Yes, temperature sensor, very good. Then?
And you have connected externally XB.
Just externally
connected right now.
XB. Okay, XB. And one more thing is there here, that is potentiometer.
Yes, sir.
Potentiometer. Okay, potentiometer means variable resistor.
Yes.
Okay, now these are various components on this board, and this board has to be powered on using, means this wires will be connecting to a battery or to any power source. The question here is, how much power source should be given to this board so that all these devices will function properly without creating any problems for us?
I think it should be 9 volts.
It should be 9 volts. So please remember always, a few more people are there. Subhash, can you please tell me what can be the power energy to be given to this? Subhash, are you online, please? Yeah, maybe unable to reach. Okay, so please listen here. So, Nivas, yeah, please tell me, you are trying to say something.
So I think it depends on the number of input and output devices, the port person.
No, please remember, all of you, it is not depending on the number of input and output, or nor in the pins, nor on the how many resistors are there. Please remember, each device functions according to that particular manufacturer data sheets. The data sheet will be given by the manufacturer. So you need to, before you power on this device, so that device will not fire down or it will not have any problems for you. So you need to check the data sheets. So every manufacturer will give you the data sheet. Data sheet means a manual. So temperature sensor, TMP35, if you go to TMP35, so please look onto my screen now. See what are all the things are there. So we are now seeing the XB. So this XB, if you see here carefully, I'm just opening the XB. If you see here XB, now you will have the details of this. You can go to their manuals, or you can check it on their websites. If you go to this description or to this features. So in the feature, what is that you are, if you are seeing here, XB is operating at, what is written on my screen, please?
3.3 volts.
Yeah, 3.3 volts at the rate 40 milliamps. So when there is a transmission, 40 milliamps of current consumption is going to be there, but this requires 3.3 volts of power supply for this XB. Okay, this is one thing. Now 3.3 volts for this XB. Now coming to we have another device, that is, what is another unit that is there on this PCB? Your TMP 35. So TMP 35, if you go here to the TMP 35 or TMP 36 or TMP 37, so if you can see, this is what your TMP, this is what I'm TMP 35 I'm referring to. This is what the temperature sensor which we are now referring here carefully. So this temperature sensor, if you see here carefully, can anybody check what is the voltage supply for this one, please? Voltage supply for the TMP35?
2.7.
Yeah, it is between 2.7 to 5.5. It is between, it is ranging, it can work from 2.7 volts to 5.5. So here, of course, the major things are your temperature sensor and your Zigbee. So, but Zigbee requires how much power supply? Just now you have seen.
3.3 volts.
So 3.3 can also be given to temperature sensor, yes or no? Your temperature sensor also works with 3.3. That's what, as per the data sheet, it is given 2.7 to 5.0. So it is in between, so 3.3 is in between 2.7 and 5. So definitely your temperature sensor also works with 3.3, whereas your Zigbee also works with 3.3. So you should not give 9 volts. Nor you should not give depending on this. So you have to check for which component requires how much energy resource, and you should not go beyond that particular maximum. Otherwise, your components will be blown out, or you are going to fire it. So that will be the biggest problem. So you need to, before you power on this particular, you prepare your device. When you prepare this, when you design this itself, it's, you are going to take care of all these things. Since you are not an electronics and rather an instrumentation engineer, you need not worry about all these things. But when as a computer science or simply an IT guy, you should know how much power should be given to this. That is the minimum thing that is required for you. So we are not asking you to design all these things. We are not asking you to know all this designing and development or preparing these PCBs. But at least you should know how much power supply you should be given before you blow out that particular device or before you make some problem to that particular device. So here, the maximum that you can give it is 3.3 volts. So usually, I connect this particular this device to the battery with 3.3, but the battery holder has been broken out for me. So can I, how do I connect this particular device so that it can give me 3.3 volts?
Arduino pins, sir.
Very good, Bharadwaj. Very good idea. So in the Arduino board, you have something like this, please. You can use the 3.3 output of your Arduino board that can be connected to your XP device. You can see that XP device is here, so that you can connect to your 3.3 plus the right color line is connected to the 3.3 and just keeping it aside here. And I will power on the Arduino board so that this particular device also gets power on. I just take the cable from the Arduino and I connect it here. And I power on. Are you able to see? I'm just connecting the Arduino cable, USB cable to my laptop. And the Arduino is powered on, enabled as my sensing system is also now powered on. You can see it here now. So the sensing system is powered on as well as, so that is now here I have a coordinator, so which is connected to the laptop, which is collecting the data. You can see the blinking lights, but let us see the signal, that is, let us see the data now, which is coming here. To see the data, what I am using here is, can you see my screen, please?
Yes, sir.
So what is it, what is that? There is a software that is a manufacturer itself will give you, that is called your XCTU. It is basically like an IDE. It is not a complete IDE, but it's a software, a tool, which will help you to monitor it. So I'm collecting the data here now, USB serial port, the COM port is selected. So now you can see, what you can see it here on the screen, please. Hello. Am I audible to you, please?
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Yeah. So what do you see it on the screen now? You see some garbage values, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, some garbage values are coming. But if you see this, what now you can see what is that happening here? What you can see?
Sir, it's hexadecimal.
Yes, these are the hexadecimal values. These are the actual packets, the packets, the data which is coming from the sensor and which has been seen on your laptop now. So let me just stop the COM port. Yes, now you can see here some data which is in hexadecimal. So if you start from a particular, suppose Again, I just open the port, which is collecting the data here. Okay, now I will again stop it. So can anybody tell me what happened actually now? Yes, Shubham, Shubham, are you online?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, please tell me what is happening here now.
It just stopped receiving.
Can you please tell me? Can you repeat?
Stopped receiving.
Yeah, it is stopped receiving here. Actually, what is being received here? Can anybody tell me? Something in the data. This is basically the data.
9600 bits of data coming from the sensor.
Yes, see here, basically you are just seeing here whether you are able to receive the data onto your coordinator or not. So this is the actual collection. Collection is happening, but of course you are not stored this data. You are not stored, you are not processed anything, and you are not analyzed the data yet. This is only to see how the actual data is coming from this ZigBee protocol. So this is the protocol information. If you see 7E followed by 001292, this is 2 bytes of information. 00 13 A2 00409B 7E AD 2B 7D 01 01 00 04 00 00 04 7E. So like this until you see for another 7E. So from the one 7E to another 7E, you can see what is 7E. 7E is like a delimiter between one packet to the other packet. This 7E is nothing but a starting delimiter. So again, what is a delimiter? For any protocol, the data that is being collected and it has been forwarded, there must be some kind of distinction between the previous data and the current data or the past data. So those delimiters are going to be useful for us to distinguish between the current data and the past data. So this is the delimiter here in this protocol by default is 7E. So if you see here 7E to another 7E, this another 7E, these are all the bytes of data. This is one packet. One packet is from one 7E to another 7E, please. 7E. 7E is nothing but the starting delimiter.
It is like that bit stepping from network.
Which are from the?
From the network we studied that bit stepping. It's like that.
Yes, from your network course you already studied. So you are receiving this data from one particular sensor node. So I will explain to you all these things on the Tuesday's class. One hour exclusive class is there for this, for you to understand and how do we collect it and how do we store it using the Python program. So Python program and how do we do it on the Raspberry Pi. So these are the things for the next week's class demonstration that I kept ready for you to have a complete understanding on collecting the data, storing the data, and processing the data, and visualizing the data, and doing some analysis. So that will be giving a complete setup data with this temperature sensors. That we will see it on the next week. That's what only a few of them are present here. So that I will just postpone it. I will not complete it today with all these things stuff here. But you will get an idea here. So once I make the availability of your Raspberry Pis, you can connect remotely the Raspberry Pis and you can also write your own Python programs. From next week onwards, you can write your own data collection, data processing, and data analysis. That is your second assignment that I'm going to give it once I give the demonstration in the next week. So I'll tell you how do you, these are your hexadecimal values. Please remember, what you are seeing is the actual hexadecimal values, which are nothing but the packets. The packet containing some sensor data. In this, you don't know which is your sensor data here, but I will tell you how to extract the sensor data, from which particular sensor it is coming, and how much is that sensor data is, and how your LEDs are glowing, and how the potentiometer is varied, and how the data can be stored. So these are all the stuffs for the next week's class discussion. So this is basically what you connected is a temperature sensor, which is analog. That analog value is connected to digital by that XB, and the digital value is shown in this hexadecimal form, in this hexadecimal value only. Please remember that important point. So here all you see the actual data transmission in your IoT wireless sensor networks, the data is getting transmitted in terms of hexadecimal values. Please do remember, this is the actual scenario. So let us understand, for one or two classes we will do some programming with Python and for data collection and data storage in the MySQL database and visualizing. A very simple exercise, but requires at least one complete hour. So on Tuesday we will plan for this one. But this is how you are going to collect your temperature analog value. This is one. So in today's demo you have seen a digital temperature value, and your another one is your analog temperature value. So let us see one servo motor example now. Let me just, that's why the time is running short. So we'll go with the any queries here, please. So now my what I'm thinking is we'll connect to Deepika. She will I'll tell her to do what to be done to operate. Yes, please.
Sir, what are the components required to perform this experiment, sir, as you are showing now?
Aryan, yes, are you, sir, the person you said that you have brought the kit last
week? Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is one example. See, what I have shown you is on a digital sensor. You already have, I think you also have DST sensor, I think, right? If I remember.
Yes, sir. Actually, sir, I have set up another experiment, sir.
No problem.
Using
no problem.
Ultrasonic sensor, sir.
With ultrasonic sensor. Okay, very good.
Yes, sir.
So you don't have DST sensor with you?
Sir, it is available, sir, but during the setup, sir, one pin broke down, sir. So I made another setup, sir, using ultrasonic sensor.
Okay, very good. Is it working or not?
Yes, sir, it's working.
Okay, can you let all others also see it? Can you show us? Is it possible for you to show now?
Or yes, sir. Sure, sir. Sir, okay. I will connect with my phone, sir.
Yes, that you can do it. That is one thing. So make it ready. So in meantime, we'll have that discussion with Deepika. Is it okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, just make it ready now. Another 5-10 minutes. After 10 minutes, we'll connect. Is it okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, Deepika, are you ready with your things there? We will connect. I will tell you the instructions to do that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please. Can you please? Can you put your camera onto your Arduino board?
Yes, sir. Just a second. I'm joining from my phone.
Okay.
Sir, is it
visible? Yeah. I'm able to see now. The Arduino board is there. Very good, fine. And you have a servo motor. Yeah, can you please show the servo motor to all of you? Can you please keep it in your hand once? It is not connected, right? Very good. Yeah. So see, please, all of you see here, this is a servo motor, a motor basically, which will control the outputs, will enable you to put a particular object in a particular angle. So you can restrict that particular rotational values onto a particular set of angle. So you can show can you just tilt your servo motor a little bit? What is that model number? I want to see that one. Okay, there is a shaft here. Yes, on that the blue color one is the servo motor. On the top of that, you have the shaft. That is the white color one. So that particular shaft is going to be rotated, and you can put your restrictions by rotating to that shaft. So where are the plus minus and the output of this one, ma'am? The wire, where is the wire of that one?
Here, sir.
Okay. So this is basically three wires are there, which are coming from that sensor. From that, of course, it's not sensor, transducer. You can call it as a actuator. In more specifically, it is an actuator. It's not a sensor here, basically. Please remember, you are controlling that shaft. So you are getting the signal. That signal is given to that particular thing. So there are three wires are there. So one wire will be your positive, another wire will be your negative, and another one will be your controller that needs to be given the signal to that particular motor. So you have the jumper wires with you, ma'am? Are you having the jumper wires?
Yes, sir.
Please put those male to male jumper wire in all those these three pins. there is a provision for you. Yes, yes. So I am unable to see your connection, Sama.
I'll just connect it, sir. One second.
Oh, no worries. Okay. Just only connect the jumper wires to those three wires. You have a female connector for the at the end of those three wires, right?
No, sir. It's male to male.
No. Jumper wires are male to male only.
Okay.
I'm talking about the output of your servo motor. Means the wires which are coming from the servo motor, you have a female connector. Sir. Yeah. Just connect three different wires to the three holes over there. That's it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think everybody might have seen that is the servo motor's the output of that one. Just we are connecting that means you are just that is like a junction. That is just you are connecting. Those so that these wires will be enabled for us to connect to your to make a provision to connect to your Arduino board now. Okay, now do you know what is which is positive, which is negative, and which is output of this one, Amma?
No, sir.
Okay.
I don't really. It's not really written here, so I'm not.
So
sure.
Nothing is written here. So can you see my screen now? Is it possible to see my screen?
Yes, sir, I can see.
No. What I'm trying to show you is my laptop screen, not my mobile phone. Can you see my screen now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So here, you please go to your Google and type the servo motor. If you know the number of that servo motor, it will be very good. Otherwise, the servo motors SG90, something like this will be there, or servo motor with Arduino. So basically, you can see these diagrams here on the nets. If you
it's
can.
SG90, sir.
Sorry, Amma, how much is the number?
Mine is SG90.
SG90 only. Oh, okay, fine. So you can see here, usually the one which is Deepika is using is basically your SG90. This is what the servo motor, what she was referring to you. What we are seeing it on the screen is this one, exactly, yes. So this is what your SG90 only, yeah. So this one, let me just show you once. So yeah, so this is what she connected three wires here. These three wires so that this can be kind of interfaced to this one. On the top, she has got a shaft that is it can be rotated. So let us now see the pin diagram of this pin diagram of this, and we'll connect it here. So what are your SG90, you said, Norma?
Yes, sir.
So SG90 tower power, you can see it here. You have an orange cable which is coming from your motor?
Yes, sir, I do.
You have an orange cable, you have a red one, and you have a black one, right?
Yes, sir. Brown one.
Amma?
Orange, red, and brown.
Brown is there. Okay, the brown is basically your ground pin that is to be connected to the ground pin of your Arduino board. And the red one is connected to your 5 volts of your Arduino board.
Okay.
And your orange one has to be connected to your, of course, the which are the pin you are getting connected here. You can use the D9. Okay, of course, the same example you can also refer to. You can, whatever the pin, accordingly in the program you have to change. But here now you are using D9, you can connect to D9. Can you connect it now from your side? Or if you show me, then I will tell you. So the red one. The red color one, which you made a connection, has to be connected to the 5 volts of your Arduino board.
Red one, yeah, 5 volts.
Nothing is shown on your screen is completely, right. So red one is connected to 5 volts of your Arduino board. The 5 volts is, which Arduino board you have? Is it Arduino, genuine one?
Yes,
it's
sir.
It is not genuine on Anama, but anyway, it is okay. You can make use of that one. That is not a problem. Okay. The 5 volts you have given to that 5 volts, right? You connected it, right? Which is your green color, right? Red color too, you connected to green color, right? Amma?
I've connected the red wire using a white wire to 5 volts. I've connected the brown wire to the port number 9 and the yellow wire to ground.
And the yellow wire? I cannot see any yellow. Yellow wire to white?
Yellow to green. Green is connected to port 9.
So I can see
if
here.
If I just use the phone numbers, it will be clear.
No. Just please show me the. You have put your camera on the Arduino board, please. That is enough. Okay. There are 3 colors here. One is white, blue, and green.
Yes.
White, blue, and green. So white is connected to which particular color wire of motor?
Red, sir.
So can you show me that white color? It is connected to the red. Red means it is it connected to 5 volts here?
Yes, sir. It is.
Okay, fine. 5 volts is correct because I cannot see read those numbers which are very small. So next to 5 is 3.3 and ground will be there. You have to be careful with you connected to 5 volts. Okay. Are you sure you connected that green color one is connected to?
Green color is connected to port number 9.
Port number 9 and that green is connected to which color wire of your motor?
Yellow, sir.
Yellow. Yellow. Miss, you mean to say orange? Oh, okay, fine.
Yeah, orange.
Yeah, okay. So red. And the blue color one?
Blue color one is connected to ground.
Blue color connected to ground, and the blue color is connected to which color wire over there?
Brown color.
Huh?
Brown, sir.
Okay, ground, fine. So now, now before you power on, you have the laptop Arduino with you, Arduino IDE?
Yeah, I have it.
So,
should I share my screen, sir?
Yes, please. That's what I stopped it. Please share your screen.
Sir, is it visible?
1 second. Not it. Yeah. Okay, now do you have the program which we have practiced on the simulator one? Servo motor one?
No, sir. Would it be available in the examples?
I think mostly it will be there also. Or we have to write our own program. We'll write our own program otherwise.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I will just tell the instructions. You just follow. Very simple only. Okay, first you include your library. Library, what is that library name?
Servo.io.
Yes, Ash include. Yes, in your simulator, the same program which you have done in the simulator, that should be fine if you have it with you. That is also Okay. Now in the setup, what needs to be done in the setup? Your servo output, that is what your, the servo pin, which is the pin which you are using here?
9, sir.
Okay. So what you need to do here? How do you say that? You need to pin mode. This is not GPIO, it is not general purpose IO.
Okay.
Okay, first you create one object variable servo. I think you are not referring to our simulator program. Create one object variable, Amma, of type servo. Yes, space. Write down some variable name, my servo one. Are you referring to our simulator program or what? Just create the object variable, that's all. Don't initialize it there.
Okay.
Semicolon.
Yes,
yeah,
sir.
In the setup, now you my servo one. What needs to be done? My servo one has to be attached to what? Which pin number? My servo one. So what is that command? My servo one.
Dot attach.
Yes. Dot attach pin number. Can a little bit maximize, Amma?
Yeah.
Is it possible for you? Can you zoom it out? Fine. Just closing brace, semicolon. Yes. Okay, now that's enough. That's enough. That's, we will not do very big programming here. That's enough. Now coming to the loop. Yes. What needs to be done in the loop? My servo one.
Right. Dot right.
Yes. My servo one dot. Right. You have to put that particular shaft into a particular direction. Put something like 100, 100 or 40 or 50, whatever it may be, one number. The number should be ranging from
0 to 100.
Not 0 to 100.
0 to 180 or
360. 180 degrees. In the simulator program, you have tried it, right? Forgot?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Closing brace, semicolon. Yeah. Now you verify the program is written correctly or not first. Yes. You give the name to your file, then you verify. Save it at a location. Yes. So done compiling, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now you please connect your Arduino board to your laptop.
Yes, sir, done.
Okay, you're not putting any camera over there,
I'll okay, just fine. It one second.
Okay, fine, it's okay. Then upload it. Upload. Burn the software, yeah. So what is the error? It's coming. There is an error here. Can you tell me what is the error is? I'm unable to read it.
Permission denied.
Permission denied.
Error go to the uploading the sketch.
Permission denied. No, actually, I could not read it. What exactly is in the can't open device. Okay. Okay. Go to tools. First, you go to the tools. Yes. Can you little bit zoom it, ma'am? Go to the
No, sir, I can't change that size. I can only
okay. I'm just looking for your port, whether your port is enabled or not there.
Okay, I'll check. Port. It is ticked, sir.
It is ticked. Okay. What is the board you have selected over there?
Arduino Uno.
Uno only. Okay. Then this /dev/tt acm0 is unable to write it.
number.
Sorry, what is the COM port number you got it here?
It's the same as this, sir.
Same as this means what is that number? Number. Did you get any number over there?
No, sir. It's only written /TTY ACM0.
I think, can you go to your My Computer once?
Yes, sir.
My Computer, go to Manage, go to Device Manager. Device Manager, you go to your USB ports. What is that you're doing, ma'am?
Like, this is Ubuntu, sir. I don't see any.
Sorry. Okay. Then, okay, go to the command prompt. Sorry, your.
Okay.
Shell prompt. You try to get the properties of this. What is that? You got TTY?
ACM0.
Yeah, just see the properties there first. Whether the write permissions given to that or not, you see executable and write permissions are there or not.
Okay.
Slash dev.
Should I just go to that path, sir?
You don't know how to check your ports there. So where these ports will be available in which location?
I haven't done it from the terminal, sir. So should I just Google that error?
No need to Google it. Permission denied means, what is the meaning of permission denied? There is you do not have access to that particular port. That is, you need to give permission. That is the only thing here now. No need to go for any. I'm just telling, but I'm just asking, you need to give permission to this port, TTY ACM0.
Yes, sir.
You need to. Use change mode? Change mode, ch mode. Are you in the super user?
I will change the super user. One second.
Change mode for that. What is that given here? Slash. What you need to give here is, you just give the right permission for your user group others, right permission. You know how to give, you know what is 777? Don't know. Okay. So do one thing.
Sir, there was actually one command that I used the last time I got this error to give the permission.
See, U plus W, user plus, user write permission, group write permission, others write permission. Yes, UGO. You can put UGO plus W.
UGO plus W. Okay.
UGO means user group others are to be given write permission space followed by, you just give slash dev. You whatever the error you got here, you see here carefully. /dev/TTY AC. Press enter. Okay.
Should I try again?
Yes, please.
It's the same error, sir. Permission denied.
That's what is not getting set over there. You need to write the write permission has to be given through that. Most likely, you are connected to the USB portal, you know?
Yes, sir, I have.
Connected to the USB, basically your ACM0 will be the port address. So what is that you have done earlier when you got that error then? Do you remember?
I used a command, sir. I'll just Google it 1 second.
Only thing is, most likely you need to write permissions to that. That is the most thing. Same thing, change mode. That is what you said. You are in the super user, no? Yeah.
Yes, sir, I am.
You are in the super user, then again, sudo again, boy. Change mode. A plus RW you are given. Okay, fine.
I'll switch on my video.
Please, that shaft has to be, it might have already done this rotation. It is rotated, right?
Yes, sir.
With 100 degrees. So you just change. So you can write your programming logic here to change continuously. How do you change that programming logic? Please tell me. So that there can be a continuous from 0 to 180 degrees shift, 180 degrees rotation, 0 to 180 degrees rotation. You put it in a loop, put one variable there.
Should I just write a for loop?
Yeah, that's what loop is, means loop, yeah, inside that. Yes, 0, yes, 180, yes. Yes, so put my server one, right? I, very simple program only, nothing very difficult. Right. So just show to the users, show to your friends about this. Okay, so actually for every I value that is getting changed, that much clear rotation is not been seen here. So put a little bit delay here.
Okay. So 1 second.
Yes. Verify it, load it again. Yes. It has already changed from 0 to 180. Can you run it once again?
Yes, sir.
It has rotated already. Anyway, so this is a small program. You can just play with this one to control some other hardware devices. If you have any other sensors, then you can start playing with that, with collecting the analog and digital. So how to collect the data and how to store it and how to process it for different visualizations and for analysis, that we will see it on the Raspberry Pi directly on the next week. Okay, now, is it okay, ma'am? Deepika?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fine. So Aryan, are you out there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Can you please connect?
Yes.
Is it okay? Connect? Yeah.
I would like to share my screen.
Yes, please. Please go ahead. Aryan, are you able to? Yeah, we can. We are able to see. Yeah, you have the ultrasonic sensor connected to your breadboard. I could see this one. But sir, there are some other items which are connected.
Yes, sir. LED is there, sir.
LED, you have kept it. Very good.
This one is ultrasonic sensor, sir.
Yeah.
LED and
yes.
Positive pin of the LED is connected to digital pin 7, yeah, to the output.
Connecting.
Sorry?
LED has no resistor, right? It will short.
No, it will work. I think it was working right now.
No, LED acting like a resistor here. He is giving as an output here. Amma, he is not as a pull-up resistor he is using here.
My screen is visual, sir. My laptop screen, sir.
Yes, please. Can you please zoom it if it is possible for you? I can see the lines, but exactly what those are lines, that is the problem for me.
Sir, I will explain, sir.
Okay. No problem.
Actually, sir, ultrasonic sensor has four pins, sir.
Yes. Perfect.
ACC and trigger, that is trigger pin, sir, and echo and ground pin, sir. So, yes, sir. So ultra pin, sir. This is a pin is connected to 5 volts, sir, and trigger pin is connected to 9, sir, pin number 9, and echo pin is connected to pin number 10.
Yep.
Yes, sir. 9 and 10 is connected to trigger and echo pin, sir. And one that is ground pin is connected to ground here. And LED positive pin is connected to output pin 7, and negative pin is connected to ground.
Yes, please.
Yes, sir. That is written in the code, sir. I have already uploaded the code, sir. I have to connect the power supply. When I power supply, sir, I have already uploaded the code, so it will work like that. When I place my hand, sir.
Yeah, when you place the hand, you are getting the echo back. Yeah.
Yes, sir. It is finding obstacle some error, so it is blinking, sir.
You are not showing the hand to your friends.
Okay. I will show that. I am just trying to give yes, sir, output also, sir.
Yes.
Then I'm placing hand here, and optical is created. And pull out my hand. At the same time, sir, distance is also showing on the screen, sir, on the serial monitor.
Yes.
What is the distance of the obstacle, sir?
Yes.
When.
Good, Aryan. Good. Can you tell me in which type of applications this ultrasonic sensor is going to be most useful for you?
It can be used in we want to design some robots.
Okay.
So while moving, it will detect obstacles, and accordingly, it will detect when it comes to the particular range of the distance.
My question is, I'll put the question in another way. Of course, you have given the answer, but I'm asking it for what type of situation. Can we use this in the water?
Water, it can be used in measure the level of the water, certain distance is achieved.
Exactly. Most of the applications nowadays, water level monitoring, people use this ultrasonic sensor very much to measure the water levels for various purposes, for agriculture purpose, for your in your home, if you have a water tank, whether it has reached to a particular level or not, water level, and you want to switch off your motor when it is reached to a particular level. So these kind of situations, this ultrasonic sensor can be very much easily used, and these are very commercially available sensors. Please don't expect a very good accuracy, but nevertheless, you'll get the complete concept. There is no doubt in that. Yeah.
Yes, sir. I was also feeling that because during when my hand is too close, it is not working properly. So like that, and
yes,
that distance is not
yes.
working. But
yes, yes.
When I'm moving like that.
Yeah, so there will be some limitations will be there only with this small commercial available sensors. But if you want a high precision and high sensitivity sensors, it will be a little bit costly will be there. Of course, you can get it from the market, but it will be costly a little bit. But you need not spend that much money for this to understand the concepts, at least at this moment. But when you really do the real practical applications, you can go for that kind of stuff. Okay, now let me tell you one thing. Yeah, thank you, Aryan. Anything to be shared? Yeah.
No, sir, it's fine. Sir.
Yeah, very good. Very good. Excellent. Excellent attempt, and really keep on working. Please do.
I'm stopping machines.
Yeah, please stop. So now coming to, of course, most of you might have seen in this today's session, completely a demo session on various things such as you are just seeing the values of the sensors or your actuators, but you are not storing them and you are not processing them and not doing some kind of analysis. So how do you store the data? That is the most important aspect for your IoTs and other things. So I will take the now next week we'll go with the, since we see has seen Arduino board today, next week we'll see the Raspberry Pi. So along the Raspberry Pi, we will see how to store the data in the Raspberry Pi through a MySQL database, and how do you process it, and how do you do some visualizations and data analysis. So that will give you some more insights on how do we handle the data more closely. Since we are a computer science and IT guys, we are most focused on those things, because we will not manufacture these things, but you will not manufacture those sensors, actuators and all, but you need to know how to use them properly and effectively and efficiently. That is most things, because until unless you don't have this hardware signal data capturing, you will not have the data analysis also to be done properly. So until unless you don't have the knowledge and the skills to handle the signals properly, you will not be able to process them also effectively. That's why everybody should be having the both the hardware and the software knowledge for this particular courses especially. Any other queries, please, for today's sessions or in the last week's sessions?
Excuse me, sir. Can you tell the component required, sir? Like for the next experiment you are going to perform, sir?
See, I just why components required for the next experiment is basically I will go with the Raspberry Pi. Okay.
Yes.
You need to have Raspberry Pi, and you need to have your digital and humidity, a DHT or a simple DHT or a digital temperature.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And the board you are showing at that time, sir?
Because you all people do not have those boards now. That's why I don't want to emphasize on that board. Only for experiment purpose, to demo purpose, I have shown you that like this boards can be done. But if you are interested, because if I show and put as an example, and you may say that we don't have these kind of boards, and how do we practice it? That is the next question comes to us.
No, sir, that's why I'm asking, sir. If possible, I will arrange that component.
This is a PCB which has I have designed and I have developed in the laboratory. So okay. You will not get it, you cannot buy it from the outside, but these are there. Because
any alternatives,
that's what alternative I'm telling you here, that is, there is not alternative. The next class, you just keep ready. If you have a Raspberry Pi with you, keep it ready. If you have a DHT or a digital temperature sensor, keep it ready. Those two things are enough. Anyway, you have the Arduino board with you, you have a breadboard with you.
Yes, sir.
So breadboard, your Arduino board, your Raspberry Pi, your jumping wires. That's enough. Then we will see how to write the Python program to store the data in your system, store the data, do some visualization and do some analysis. That we will do it.
Okay, sir.
That should be fine. So that will be easy for everybody. And those who don't have the Raspberry Pis, do not worry. After completing the demos are over, I will make the Raspberry Pis remotely available for you. so that you can access them. Those Raspberry Pis will be there in the lab or in my home. You can connect those Raspberry Pis and you can access and write the programs. Even those who don't have the Raspberry Pis, that is what I'm trying to say. Those who have, you can do it on your own practice. It is not compulsory to buy. It is not compulsory to buy all those things. That's what I was trying to say. Okay, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Any other queries, please?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
In assignment parts, we have to attach screenshots of output and.
Yeah. That is must, because until unless you don't put, how do I know that there you have executed them all?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, in Raspberry Pi, do we have any specific analog ports like the way we have in Arduino?
No, Amma. Those are GPIO ports only.
Okay, sir.
That's why when you go for the Raspberry Pi, you need to have other microcontroller to convert your analog to digital. There should be a provision for you. That's why this last question Bharadwaj has asked in the last week. Pranav Bharadwaj, what he has asked is basically he was you can use your Arduino connection to your Raspberry Pi. If you can do it, that is fine. I'll tell you if you don't know how to do that one. But other than that, if you have something like these boards which I've shown to you, so those Zigbees are already having inbuilt microcontrollers. So there are so many ways. There are different ways. All these things. That's why you can do it. You need to have your creativity. That is the only thing here to make best use of those devices.
Sir, any other queries? Yes, can you take a class on how to design PCBs and all that? You can place order.
But we don't have PCB machine here now. Only I can show it to you as a simulator. Simulator we have to go by.
Yes, sir. Using simulator only. Later we can
we'll
place
do,
order.
We'll do it. We'll do it. Once you get some ideas on completing all these aspects, we'll go that one. Because it is basically your electronics and instrumentation guys topic, that is basically. But nevertheless, since you asked, we'll do it. Don't worry. In the sessions, we'll have. Yeah. Any other queries, please?
Sir, how we are getting the data from XBs?
Very good question, Rupesh. Since you are not, we have not completed it actually. See, can you see here? Still, I have connected this. Can you see here now on this my screen? Oh, sorry. One second, I'm presenting my screen. Hold on. Can you see it on my screen now?
Yes, sir.
So this is the actual data, Rupesh. The data between device to device, this is how your actual data looks like. These are packets. These are all so many packets. It's a continuous data which is coming here.
Yes, sir.
I will just tell you, hold on, just hold on one second. Let me. See, I have written one book chapter for this. How do you collect the data and how do you prepare a mesh network and all? Can you see my screen now? What is written here?
Yes, sir.
I will just put this material on the course page today. Just read like a story. You people may not understand immediately, but just read like a story. Okay. First, you read like a story. All these steps I will explain to you. First, you all of you read it for the next week. Next Friday, we will give the demonstration for these things. What is this data? What is this and all? You are a Zigbee command, how it looks like. So if everybody can read this one, I'll give 1 week time for you to see. This is your actual packet. The packet starts from 70, followed by packet length, followed by from which particular source it is coming. What is the actual payload? what is in pin number 18, pin number 19, pin number 20, that is your temperature sensor, potentiometer, and your digital LED to be blown on off, and followed by the checksum. This is how your actual packet looks like. The packet structure is this. So this is your, these are all the packets which are coming here. In computer networks, you might have studied, what is a packet? What is a packet, please? Once you collect the data, you can design your GUI, graphical user interface, like this. I'll just show it on my screen once. You can see it on my screen here. You can, this program is developed using C#, like this, the GUI. You can collect the data from the ports and collect the data from the sensors like this. You will get the temperature sensor. You can send the signal from your GUI to those ports. So if you can understand this complete scenario of developing the GUI, graphical user interface, this is your graphical user interface, collecting the data, storing it in your system, and doing like this. Like this, we'll do it by Python. Of course, this program is written using C# 11 years back. But now, since Python is being used mostly, we'll use Python to develop this kind of GUI. Of course, this these are all coming as an assignment to you. I will tell the steps and I will tell the complete details, but you need to design and develop those things. So this next week, we'll see how you are collecting the data and how you are storing it and how you are processing the data. This is a very, very important step for all of you. This we will see it on the next week, please. Yeah. Any other queries?
Sir, in a previous class, you have discussed a simple program on a Arduino simulator, but it is not running on my PC.
Can you open your system? Can you present your system now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please connect it now.
Sir, I think you have to stop presenting.
Yeah, one second. Yeah. Which program are you referring to, Rupesh?
Here it is, sir. Sir, the volt value, when I change it through from here, it is not changing. It is constant 2300.
2300. Where did you give the volt value? You are putting a delay of volt value.
Volt pin should be A0.
Volt pin I had set at year 0 and I am changing from here.
Okay.
But the delay is not changing.
Well, delay means what is the delay here? Delay, you put it as a volt pin, volt value you are giving. First, you please remove the volt value.
Volt
put it in comments. Just put it in comments first.
Sir, here in I and the volt value, I am reading analog read from volt pin here, sir.
The next statement, what is the next statement?
Next statement is a digital write LED pin high, means okay. on 13th pin, LED pin, it is high.
Okay, what is the next statement?
Then, sir, it is delay of volt value, which is I am reading from
A0. Okay, you put this statement in comments.
Which delay value?
Yes.
Delay, sir.
Yes, please. Yeah, put it in comments. Yes, the next one also, next to next also, put it in comments. Next one also. Now load it. Your pin number 13. Your pin number 13 itself is not glowing there.
Sir, here it is, pin number 13, sir.
Yes, yes, there is a pin number 13, you have mentioned it. LED pin.
Sir, that Volton value is 0, sir, not A0. It should be either 14 or A0, no, sir.
All symbols not transmitted.
No, that is okay. If old pin is 0 is fine, that is it will be treated as A0 only. Now you please change the board actually first. Which board are you using here?
Which sorry. It is, you know, version 3, sir.
Okay, that should also be fine. Can you send me this code? I will check it. I'm unable to see those instructions properly. Can you send me this code to my email? I'll check it and get back to you.
Okay, sir.
I'll run it on my system and check it and get back to you. Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Any other queries, please, for anybody? Okay, so then we will meet on Tuesday again with the Raspberry Pi's data collection, sensor data collection and storing. Okay, then we'll meet on Tuesday. Thank you. Thank you, one and all. Take care. Yeah. Bye.
Thank you, sir.